Good morning, students. In yesterday class, we discussed how carbon make different type compounds. Because carbon neither gain nor lose, it share the electrons and form covalent compounds. Students, today we will discuss about allotropes of carbon and versatile nature of carbon. Why carbon make lot of compounds? So at first we explain what are allotropes. Friends, allotropes means that have more than one form. The substance having same physical state but different physical property, that known as allotropes. Allotropes means they having same physical state, but different physical property. Physical properties, chemical property almost may be same. Chemical properties almost same, but reactivity may be different. One is more reactive, other is less reactive. Friends, carbon show three allotropes. One is diamond, other one graphite and fullerene. We already studied in lower class diamond. Diamond is substance having highest melting point, hardest substance of carbon. Diamond, other one is graphite and third we'll discuss another allotrope, that known as fullerene. Now we go in detail diamond, graphite and fullerene structure. Three dimensional network like solid. In that diamond, students, carbon has four valency. So one carbon attached to four other carbon atom like this. In a tetrahedral arrangement, in single bonds like this one, every carbon attached to four other carbon. Each carbon again it attaches to total four carbon. You can see in your NCRT book at page number 61, students, given the structure of diamond, graphite and fullerene. Now we can make by Bohr and stick model its a structure of diamond. So we try. This carbon attached to three other carbon. If it attached another one carbon, then like this, and further we can join other carbon also. In this way. So if you attached further more carbons, so it's formed like a diamond, because every carbon attached to four other carbon in tetrahedral rigid structure, three dimensional network solid. So these are extremely stable compound, and very, although there are covalent bond, but it is very high melting and boiling point, hardest substance. And it do not pass current. Why? All electrons or valency are bonded, no free electron. so it could not pass current, it is insulator. Other allotrope is graphite, and graphite has layer structure. In that layer structure, one carbon attached to three other carbon atom. In graphite, one carbon attached to three other carbon atom, like hexagonal layer structure. It's attached like hexagon. And another layer, every carbon attached three other carbon, but one valency free, that electron make multiple bond or double bond, pi bond, this bond to other atoms. Students, in graphite, one carbon attached to three other carbon atoms. Suppose this one carbon attached to this three carbon. Every carbon attached to three other carbon, and one electron is free. It has hexagonal layer structure. So that layer structure can slip to one layer to other layer. And that electron, free electron, can make pi bond, means double bond, multiple bond. And one layer attached to other layer, and they also bonded like this, weak bond, pi bond, and that electron is free, it can pass current. So it have layer structure. That is main difference. In diamond, all valency are bonded, but in graphite, one electron free, that can pass current, heat and electricity, it slip one layer to other layer. So it is used as lubricating, as dry lubricant in machines, different parts that have frictional, they are used in different machineries. Other allotrope is fullerene. That fullerene, the American architect Buckminster Fuller discovered this allotrope, and this similar to like football or a soccer ball. So its name of that scientist, it denoted by carbon 60 or carbon 70 fullerene. It have pentagonal and hexagonal ring like structure. Its structure similar to like football or volleyball. It has pentagonal ring and hexagonal ring structure. Every pentagonal ring attached to a hexagonal ring like this, whole complete structure. If we complete, then every hexagonal and pentagonal ring . So in total carbon 60 have 12 pentagonal and 20 hexagonal ring structure. In carbon 70 there are 12 pentagonal and 12 pentagonal and 25 hexagonal ring structure. And every carbon also attached to three other carbon atom in this. So one electron is free, it can pass also current, means fullerenes used for making nanotubes, and they are hollow space, geodesic dome like structure for making tube. You can search in detail on Wikipedia or in Google about fullerenes. Diamond graphite fullerene all are in solid state, but they have different property. Diamond is insulator, graphite is conductor, very soft and lubricant, and fullerene is a hollow space, geodesic dome like structure, hexagonal and pentagonal ring type structure, all are solid. Slightly they have, when they burn, they produce whole carbon dioxide. Students, in these days we can make diamond also. If we apply very high pressure and high temperature, then we can prepare diamond. That diamond is as like natural diamond, but very small size. So which allotrope is most stable form? Such type question comes in exam. Out of these, diamond, graphite and fullerene, which is most stable form? So graphite is most stable form, and this we will discuss in 11th class, because Gibbs energy of formation and enthalpy of formation, that two words we will study in 11th class. Due to that, graphite is most stable form and diamond and fullerenes are slightly less stable. Now we discussed versatile nature of carbon. Students, another property of carbon is versatile nature of carbon. Versatile means a different form. Carbon makes millions of different compounds. What are the region? If we compare the number of carbon, one side carbon, other all carbon, then carbon compounds is more number than remaining 117 elements. So that there are two regions. First one is catenation. Friends, catenation means self-linking property of any element. Catenation means self-linking property of any element. So carbon can make a long chain compound. It can make single bond, double bond, triple bond also, and ring shape. So that property found in carbon highest. It can, one carbon attached to other carbon as a straight line, it can make ring. Carbon-carbon can make double bond, multiple bonds. It can make like triple bonds. This property, it's make a special to comparison than others. When it makes single bond, then such type compounds known as saturated compound. We will discuss in later on what are saturated compounds. When it make double bond, carbon-carbon double and carbon-carbon triple bond, means multiple bond, then it known as unsaturated compounds. Unsaturated. And when it make single bond, that time known as saturated. And it can make ring type, branch, side chain. So due to that property, that have millions type compounds formation. That one nature, carbon. What are the reason of the catenation? Because carbon-carbon bond is very strong bond, and it holds tightly the number of electrons, the shared pair of electrons, comparison than others. Other element also found some catenation, silicon and sulfur, but slightly lesser than. After 6-7 molecule, that is slightly less stable. Other property of that region is tetravalency. Students, carbon valency for and one carbon have four hands, we know, and that valency it can make bond with other elements like oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, halogen, chlorine. So that can make a special carbon have four valency, it can attach to other element like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, chlorine, fluorine, bromine, we can say halogens. So when they attached, that make a special property. So that a different, that property decided by these elements. So that we will discuss in different functional groups. So these two nature, carbon has tetravalency and catenation, they make a special. And more than 60 million compounds found of the carbon. In that, due to this region, it found lot of compounds. Students, carbon makes special features to the characteristics. One is catenation, self-linking property, other one is tetravalency. Due to these two characteristics, it's make lot of compounds, that compound known as organic compounds. Earlier, these compounds, that is a theory produced, they can create only living things. Means, we can't prepare in laboratory. A Swedish chemist, Berzelius, Berzelius proposed a theory, that theory known as vital force theory in 1815. That organic compound we can't prepare in laboratory, means they can produce only living things, means from animals and plants we can prepare. But a scientist, German scientist, Friedrich Wöhler, in 1828, a German chemist, Friedrich Wöhler, in 1828, these organic compounds, first organic compound, urea, prepared in laboratory from a compound that known as ammonium cyanate. First organic compound prepared in laboratory is urea from an inorganic substance, means ammonium cyanate, ammonium cyanate. Ammonium cyanate. So students, you can write these compounds molecular formula, ammonium NH4CNO, ammonium cyanate. So, and what is the formula of urea? Urea formula I can write like this, NH2CONH2. That formula, this one is organic and this one inorganic because there is separate ions. So ammonium cyanate CNO minus, that is negatively charged, and ammonium is a ion positive charge. And when we rearrange, then it changes into urea. First organic compound, urea, prepared by Friedrich Wöhler, 1828. Due to this theory, vital force theory is disapproved. Means existence of vital force theory is after study of the, after preparation of the urea in laboratory from inorganic substance ammonium cyanate, then this theory is cancelled, disapproved by the German scientist. So in these days, we can prepare many organic compounds. After that, acetic acid, methane, prepare in laboratory, and in the, now we can prepare all the living things. Means we can prepare a living thing in inorganic compounds. So that theory of existence is removed in 1828. Now we discussed again saturated and unsaturated compounds. Now students, we explain what are saturated. Saturated and unsaturated, how can we make? We can make in such a way long chain compound. We earlier discussed formation of a methane. Now we explain one more compounds, ethane, propane, like this. So first we can write a carbon C, and we know carbon has 4 valency. So all the valency we can represent like hydrogen, that is methane in 2 dimensions we represent it like this, but actual structure slightly different. You can explain like this one. So one carbon attached to 4 other carbon atom and all as single bond. This compound we can write here like a molecular formula CH4, because one carbon, 4 hydrogen, all they make single bond and sharing of one electron. Students, how can we connect to other carbon this? So we have to remove any one hydrogen because it tetravalency. We want to make a catenation means chain. So we remove one hydrogen and connect another carbon to by that bond. So in this way, so 2 carbon can join. So another compound formation like this. So for making another chain, first you make single bond, carbon carbon single bond. That is first step. At first we make at least single bond, then remaining valency we can satisfy by hydrogen, because every carbon has 4 valency, 1, 2, 3, and you write 4th one. In another, this carbon also you can represent this. So now we can count total carbon 1, 2, then its molecular formula is C2. Hydrogen how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So C2H6. In similar way, if we want to more number of carbon in this, then we have to remove any one of the hydrogen. So I can join like this. Every carbon has 4 valency. By bond and stick model we can explain in this, like this one. So students, but in straight line you can make one single bond and other also like this. So remaining valency how can you write? By counting 1. So you write 2, 3, 4. Every carbon you write in this way. Like this. Then combined its molecular formula C3, 1, 2, 3, and hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. C3H8. And further, you can make 4 carbon, 5, 6 carbon in this way. But what are the name of these compounds? We will discuss in detail IUPAC nomenclature. IUPAC nomenclature, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. We already discussed this nomenclature of this in 9th class. This beside all the compounds a particular nomenclature in organic compounds. So one carbon, this compound known as methane, 2 carbon is ethane, and then propane. We will discuss in detail that word, this meth, for meth, for single carbon. If one carbon, single bond, then we write a suffix N. Two carbon, then eth, eth, then N, ethane. If double and triple, then this suffix is change, propane. In similar way, you can write four carbon. When you write four carbon, like state change, at first how can you write four, then you can represent like hydrogen. This is saturated hydrocarbon, means the carbon and hydrogen single bond. In that hydrocarbon have between carbon carbon single bond, hydrogen always make single. So you can write here in detail and molecular formula. These are molecular, means combined. This one is structural formula, detail structure, expanded form. We can write in small formula also. So this formula is C4H10, and its name is butane. Butane. After that, 5 carbon you can write and complete the hydrogen. Then 6 carbon, straight chain compound, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in this way you can make long chain, and number of carbon and hydrogen you can write. Such type compounds known as saturated hydrocarbon. And now students, we explain the compound make double or triple bond. For writing double or triple bond, at first we required at least 2 carbon. So first step, we make at least single bond, and then we make double bond. After that, we complete the remaining valency, that hydrogen remaining only 2. So this one is a double bond compound, and we can represent like this ball and stick model. In this you can observe one is like straight bond, other is slightly this partial. So one is sigma or single bond, other one pi bond, that is weak bond. But in this model we can't explain properly that bond. So students, like this there is structure particular this compound, and its name we will discuss later. 2 carbon eth, and a suffix we write ene. So its name is ethene. And its formula, how can you write? 2 carbon C2, hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4, C2H4. If we explain 3 carbon, 4 carbon, then you can write, at first we make double bond, and then you can write one more carbon. Then we complete the remaining valency by writing hydrogen. This carbon, how many hydrogen can attach? 1, 2, 3. 3 valency already satisfy. Only we can write one hydrogen, above or below, no problem. And this carbon, you write 3 hydrogen. So its formula is C3, 1, 2, 3, hydrogen you can count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, C3H6. If you write more, then you can add one more carbon. Double bond in the compound, in between or starting, you can write anywhere. Compound is different. So only one hydrogen we need. It's required two hydrogen to satisfy four valency of carbon like this. Then you count 1, 2, 3, 4. C4 hydrogen is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. C4H8. In these compounds we can see the difference: one carbon, two hydrogen only. One carbon and two hydrogen. One carbon, two hydrogen. That is a characteristics we will discuss later on. They have double or they can make multiple bond, triple bond also. If we make three bonds like this, so such type compound also formation, that known as unsaturated compounds. And only one valency remaining, you can write H. So what are the name of this compound? This compound is ETH and a particular suffix YNE. Ion we write for triple bond. So you can write its formula C2, 1, 2 and hydrogen 2, C2H2 only. If you write more number of carbon, students, those compound having either double or triple known as unsaturated hydrocarbon. Between carbon-carbon, double or triple bond known as unsaturated. Between carbon-carbon have only single bond, that is saturated hydrocarbon. Now we explain normal nomenclature of this compound. Now students, we write nomenclature of normal hydrocarbon. So first we need a word root, and then we write any suffix. So if the compound having only one carbon, then we write the word root is METH, meth. And if they having only single bond, between carbon-carbon, single bond, then we write suffix N. If having double bond, then we write ene. If I have triple bond, then write ine. Students, if I have single bond, then we suffix write N. Double bond, then we write ene. Triple bond between carbon-carbon, then we write ine. These, out of these three suffix, we write only one. If single bond, then ene, one carbon, meth. If two carbon, ETH, eth. Three carbon, you write prof. Four carbon, you write but. This not but, it's a pronounce as a but. If five carbon is pent, six carbon if any compound, then hex. If seven carbon, then hept. Eight carbon if any compound have, you write oct, oct. Nine carbon, then non. And 10 carbon, then you write dec, DEC. These are word root. If I have single bond, it means one carbon and all have like this only. So what is the name of that compound? There is only carbon, so that name is METH and N means methane. If two carbon only single bond and all are hydrogen, then its name is, what are the name of two carbon? 1, 2. Two carbon means we find in this table ETH, eighth ETH, and single bond, then we write suffix ane, ethane. If there is double bond, then ethene. If triple bond, then ethyne. If you write further, three carbon, and then you write hydrogen by counting the hydrogen, or you write the complete structure, long chain structure. Initially you write like this structure, after we write combined structure, so its name is 1, 2, 3, 3 carbon, then find the from this table prop, so name is propane, propane. And further, if 4 carbon, then butane, 5 pentane, 6 hexane, then heptane, octane, nonane, and decane. If have double bond like 2 carbon, then you write hydrogen, then its word root we select 2 carbon, ETH, eth, and suffix we write ene. Why we write ene? Because double bond, ethene. If triple bond, carbon-carbon having at least, then its name is 2 carbon name, again word root ETH, eth, and wine, ethyne. If 3 carbon, propyne, 4 butyne, pentyne in this way. And in detail, we will discuss in later on. Students, in this way, you can write more number of carbon atom, and we will discuss detail nomenclature tomorrow and further classes. So thoroughly study your NCERT book, and you can get more information about vital theory, versatile nature of carbon, and allotropes of carbon in from internet, or you can see in your NCERT book also, and writes in your notebook, make notes, and tomorrow we will discuss nomenclature of further more organic compounds, carbon compounds. If you have any problem, then write comment box, share needy student. Thank you. Have a nice day.